prophecy has been said at the beginning of this year concerning 2015, or sorry, 2015, it will come to pass. Yeah. You see, the way the devil is doing it, but here on the path, that prophecy will come to pass. It's for me 2015. Then you start praying, and it must come to pass. It is your life. You only come to the world once. The Bible says, after death, come. One. Somebody's life has been wasted. I mean, we had it today. Somebody that I saw last year, very young couple, who their life has been wasted. And that's it. This person, they get money. I don't want to go for that. For some people not to decode what I'm saying. But if the life is gone. You are alive. God is giving you opportunity. Amen. With all what Pastor is saying, it's for you to live a good life and make it. And that's why Luke 16:16, that's what we're about to do now. He said, they press. Luke 16:16, let's see. And we stand to pray. Luke 16:16, let's stand up. We are praying.
They all had a prophet. While unto John, since that time, the kingdom of God is preached, and every man passes on into it.
Some version. And then, praise into it. I don't have anything against something, you know, but please, when you are confused, King James Version or in King James Version, press into it. To press. Press is, you don't be playing. To press something. Answer me. People are pressing into prophecy because they don't want it to come to pass. Even people are so close to you, they want to be pace setters. They want to be the first person. Then they can pass it down to you. They like you so far, they are ahead of you. Once you are ahead of them, you become their enemy. They like you because they are. It's my very good friend. He always put money in our family. He always go over here, shakarani. That day, he don't do anything. You see, when the guy they do, he say, he pass you. You are under. No problem. He wants to be doing out money. I'm helping your family. I'm helping your business. You say, he say, nice guy. When I was leaving my former church, the last message I preached, I didn't know he was talking about me. My wife reminded me some weeks ago. Grace, I said, when the glory of God properly rise upon you, according to Isaiah 61-3, very few people can stand it. Very, very few people can stand it. It's a lie. I'm so happy for your promotion. I'm so happy. It's because they are higher than you. They don't promote you from a worker to supervisor, but they are the manager. They don't promote you to a star manager. Whatever said, you are not somebody that should be dominated. Every said, you cannot be limited. Every said is for a season. Sir, upon me. Because that's why he said, after you have suffered for a while. Every said, in Indianapolis, your suffering will not be for 5 years because it's time to repackage, remodel you. They cannot limit you. And so when God says, it is your season, it is your year, it is your time, I'm going to promote you. They don't know what to say. Oh, Shogune. He has gone to go and do good to do. It's not possible. I know her now. She has her sense. She cannot even speak correct English. When money is speaking, God will see.
Yes,
are you hearing me?
Yes,
when money, people from where I come from, those states are making the states. And God created those states. For a long time, when they are still under those states, Ogun State, all of them are making it. That they are living on this earth. We always say, our friends that they are, but what with my people in my look at his English. He said went. He said this. I'm wasting time. Devil is not interested in your semantics. If you like, you want to know everything, I'm able to speak. I wanna. Devil is not interested in threatening to give, to steal, and to destroy. Amen. When money speaks, Ghana will keep quiet. You'll be speaking bad English. They will say, that is the correct. Everybody, you don't have money. Your own is just grammar. When we are family meeting, anger and grammar. No, what you are saying is let it stop with grammar. Yes. Okay, we are part. We said we are part of you. Now, let me do. Yes.
Amen.
The Lord, who is that person? The Lord will listen to you.
Amen.
My spiritual brother said, I raised a prayer point here. He said he's going to develop a book on it. I said, what? He said, and the Lord had the voice of Elijah. My spiritual brother said, the thing has been disturbing him that you know that prayer. He said, yes, sir. Maybe I just left. He said, from voice of somebody to be heard in heaven. That is on heart. It's heard already.
Yeah.
If you can give a loud, heavenly, accepted, heart-dominated heaven. May your voice be heard by God in the name. You want to press into prophecy. You want to press into prophecy. Now, how do you know we only have seven prayer points? We are closing by nine. Whoever is coming to close with me. We have seven prayer points. How do you locate? How do you press into prophecy? You must locate the right word. Locate the right word. Amen. I will be here. Yeah, it's the right word. Why? Somebody has been dominating, oppressing you. You release the word. Because the word is fire. The word is power. The word was formed. The word formed many things. That's why it was in the word. Was inside the word. Things were. Promotion that has never been in existence. For the person that will give the loud testimony, I prophesy that promotion is into the Lord! The same way by the spirit of prophecy, I look at some of my books. I said, God, you have been so awesome. And I was thanking him. Many prophecies have been come, and people are enjoying it. Amen. I just met a man. I said, sir, you are going to get a job in Indianapolis that you are a recently graduate. I can use that one. You are going to get a job that people will never believe that. Number one, a fresh graduate cannot get it. Number two, you are from Nigeria. Number three, you have accent. Number four, you only want all the indices that cannot have. But I said, God says you will get a job. It will be the signature of eyes. People will look at it and wonder, how did he get it? And the guy got it. He called me, he talked to mommy, said mommy, called her, mommy, said mommy, it's still difficult for me to believe that I can get, because heaven said so. Because heaven said so. And this person in his place, in his church, who were in the same church before, he did that of do anything he has to do in the house of God. No people that want to be, nobody can talk to them. And so God answered. God is a prophecy of God and it came to pass. Amen. Amen. And that's why I like that word. You see, I say it all the time, it's a prophetic, powerful word. What eyes have not seen. People see glory. Glory will be seen. That's why I say, arise and shine for the glory of God has risen. People see. God said, what eyes have not seen. What? That is beyond the hearts of men. Is what will happen to you.
Yeah.
You are not with me. I stand as a prophet of Jehovah. And I prophesy into your life. I ask what eyes have not seen. That is not the glory of God. Within the next 6 months. Within the next 6 months. What I hear have not heard. That is God miraculous works, wonders of Jehovah. As many that are saying that, receive it now. You must locate the right word. Number two, you must identify the enemy. 1 Corinthians 16 says, there are many adversaries. He identified the enemy. Amen. I told this woman, I didn't tell my father, when I was ordained, she was ordained as a pastor. They said, she's ordained with you, she's not here physically. And I told her, when daddy comes, he will do it. I didn't even tell him. You know, he was causing service of God. Because the spirit of God is one. So I told her, I said, Mama, join your faith with me. Once I identify an enemy, because I don't want to identify an enemy for you to be saying, Pastor, I My husband, and he's a nice person. I identify enemy. Doors have been opened. There are many adversaries. I don't joke with my life. Are you hearing me? If they say it's my papa, man, I'm not saying you should die, but man, let there be Lot and Abraham separation. Because I want to enjoy my life. After death, the Bible says, come judgment. That your sister that is sitting on you, you are here, is sitting on your head like this. Because he has sat, that's the way he has sat on the head of everybody in your family. That person, you are here. By the power of the Most High God, if that woman is refusing to stand up and let you rise up, by thunder, by fire, I remove her in the name. It is settled. Yes. It is done. Yes. It is done. Yes. It is done. Yes. In the city of Indianapolis, because I want to know a lot of witchcraft powers. All those who are using witchcraft power in this city, and if they are using it against themselves, no problem. Because they are using it against the child of God. They have got the wrong person. Amen?
Yes.
Said she all Africans. She always deal with them. She always deal with all Africans. I told my wife, she has done it to a wrong person. And she engineered my wife to be fired from a place of work. She wrote a letter of fire. The DON did not ask her to. She just wrote it. And I did some research. I like research. They say, I push my shame here. The woman has been doing it to a lot of Africans. We were on that place. I went on the altar. I said, but this one, spirit of mistakes and error, must enter into her. She fired her. She will be hired. And she has. You see, I will give them for your life in that place. So it has been decided that somebody must be fired. But she has fired her. She needs to be rehired and for her to be fired. And when that prayer, he said, Mama, Mama was just thinking, hey, we should be looking. I said, okay, you know, my wife now, let's be looking for job. I don't know. As we were driving, looking for job, I was telling God, God, it's not over in that place. Or she said she wants to leave the place. I said, as she shaped up by me, spirit of mistake and error. What happened to her? She was fired. He had been doing it. He had the word of the Lord, somebody. They have been doing it, they have been oppressing people. But from today, whoever is still oppressing you, we will take the wrath of the Lord. Number three, you need to be vigilant. Number four, don't be passive. Don't be passive. A prophecy has come. My spiritual father gave some prophecy. I'm going to release it upon you. He has given it to that. When I show him, he said, hey, this is it. You can pass it. I kept it. And I'm releasing it upon your children. Amen? A prophecy has been said concerning you. You have to, oh my, the continue. You stay with it. It is my compromise. Even if you are a liar. Amen?
Amen?
You have to have faith. You must have
faith.
Somebody was before the man of God. What is so wrong? He has said, excuse me, sir. He's still debating the man God's doing. And I said, it is well. You know my word. I said, it is well. It is well. It is well. You are. Oh, you don't have faith. Nothing can work. You must have faith. Number six, trust. You must trust him. He said, let us go to the other side. And storm arose. You didn't trust me. And it's me, the Lord Jesus. I told you, the disciples, let us go to the other side. Storm arose. You can't go under now. Because why? I said so. That we are going to the other side. You must get to the other side. Whoever is saying you will not see the end of 2015. You have not seen the end of 2015. What God has in store for you in 2016 has never happened to you before since you are born. Whoever is saying you will not see the end of 2019, the person is a liar.
Yes.
Because the Lord has not said to you. Who is it that sees that coming to pass when everyone has not commanded you? Everybody that says you will not see the end of 2015, you will see the end of 2015.
Yes.
And you will see your very end.
Yes.
Fasting. Everyone will be with you. In the name of Jesus. Are you ready to pray? Are you ready to pray? Seven prayers we want to close. Are you ready to pray? Father, we thank you. We take this up today. Jesus, we answer me. Today. Hallelujah.